This video will look at how you can view and explore coding in a more expansive project. To facilitate this, I'm going to open a brand new sample project using the option on the main NVivo screen. This will copy a version of the Environmental Change Down East project to my drive for me to work with. If you saw the first video in this series, you will have seen that this project is expansive. It has images, interviews, literature, news articles, and an extensive coding framework already built in. This is a perfect project for us to look at coding in a bit more detail. First of all, we can see that these researchers have used an efficient and effective coding framework. Sentiment coding is an important part of this. We can see this under their attitude code. Every time they've coded something in an interview or other source, they've coded it to a theme, such as economy, and also to one of the attitude themes, such as negative. This is a very effective framework. It avoids duplication in their coding framework. You could imagine how bloated this structure would be if we had negative about the economy, neutral about the economy, positive about the economy, mixed about the economy, positive about community change, neutral about community change, mixed about community change, negative about community change, and so on. You get the picture. So this is a very effective and efficient coding structure. If we want to explore one of these codes in a lot more detail, for example economy, all we need to do is double click and that code will open. Whenever we're looking at a code, you'll find blue hyperlinks to show you a link to the source this came from. So we can see this particular text here is coded to economy within the Cooper presentation. As I scroll down, I can see further sources such as this text from the NCC Turtle project. This text from the Economic and Market Value of Coast and Estuaries file. As I go down further, I can see some individual references. These might seem hard to interpret, but if you look at them, you'll see these are timestamps. As Betty and Paul's interview is a video, there's some direct coding onto that timeline. So I can see these researchers have identified the theme of economy at 37.6 seconds through to 1 minute 2.9 seconds, and there's further references as we go down. You can see there's an awful lot of text and audio and areas of images that have been coded to this particular theme. To help us explore this further, we can move from this view, which is references, to the summary view. You'll find it on the tab on the right hand side. As I go to summary, it shows me all of the individual files that have been coded to this particular theme. By clicking on one of the items at top, I can change the order of this list. This makes it very easy for me to see that the survey responses have the highest number of references, followed by Twitter, then Barbara's interview, then Thomas's interview, and so on. We've already seen the references view, which shows us the individual areas and text that have been coded to that particular theme. Underneath the references tab, you'll see a variety of different tabs, and this varies on your project and the kind of source types you've been coding. In this example, I can see text, PDF, picture, audio, video, and dataset. This tells me that each of these different source types have coding to economy. If I click on text, it will show me the individual text files across the top, such as Dorothy's interview. I can click on them and see those textual references. If I move down to PDF, I get a similar kind of view, but this time it shows me the entire source type, but it grays out anything that isn't linked to the particular theme you're looking at. As I move to the picture tab, I can see there are some areas of pictures coded to this as well. In this case, the carrot with boundary, and the competing water uses images. I can definitely see why. Here there's some annotations that talk of the tension between those commercial fishing boats and recreational fishing boats, a clear sign of different areas of the economy. If I move down to audio, I can see a snippet of Helen's interview. And if I click play,
I don't want to sacrifice one for the sake of the other.
It is very clearly allowing me to listen to the very small snippet of the interview that was coded to this theme. I get a very similar experience with video, seeing both the video and the audio time span, and the option to press play to listen back to which areas of this video were coded to. Finally, with dataset, it will show me the individual datasets with coding to economy, give me the option to click between them, and then I will see the individual cells with those coding. There's a much more detailed way in which we can explore any of our codes, such as that of economy, using queries which we'll look at in later videos. You'll also see some quick links at the top to generate charts, compare diagrams, explore diagrams, and word cloud. Clicking on these is a very quick shortcut to generate some of the queries that we'll be looking at in later videos. For example, clicking on the word frequency button has generated a word frequency query result for this particular code. What this will do is it will identify every individual word under the economy theme, and then it will count how many times that appears. The more times the word appears, the bigger it appears on this word cloud. This is clearly showing me that fish, people, know, water, fish, and think are the most frequently used words in the economy theme. It is important to remember that this only relates to the words, so all of those image references and direct coding to timestamps isn't reflected in this diagram. As we return to the code we were looking at, and back to the References tab, you'll also see how this is a useful view for you to refine your coding further. You can highlight any reference in this view, right-click, and choose Uncode. You've also got the option to uncode from this code, which is a nice way for you to review your coding and refine it as required. Hopefully this gives you a really good overview of how you can explore any of your codes. Later videos will look at some of the queries where you can do this in further detail.